Well, it's time for lunch, so let's head over to the kitchen and say hello. A special hello on a Thursday to have Judy Gallagher in our kitchen. Hi, Judy.
Scott, I just had to come in and see you. I missed you so much. I just said, let's just show up on a Thursday. And one of the reasons is because I have a delicious sweet treat for you. I am going to be making a peach cream cake, but there's actually no cream cheese or anything like that in it. It's similar to one of those ooey gooey butter cakes that you hear about from people in Minnesota, but we're using those beautiful fresh peaches from Georgia that I picked up at Yoder's Produce Market. This is the time of year I'm getting a basket, and I have several different recipes. And guess what I brought in today? I brought in my new book, Reflections and Recipes of Chef Judy Gallagher. You'll be able to order this right now online on Amazon and Barnes & Noble online, coming to your bookstores next month. I'll be back in just a few minutes to start cooking. That's right, Scott, we're ready to get going. So in the mixer, I have 1/3 cup of sugar. And to that, I'm going to add a whole egg and one egg yolk. And you know, I always label those leftover egg whites and put them in the refrigerator, because just whipping up that extra egg white to certain recipes is just gonna give you more fluff, and it's gonna be really good. So just label it. You've got 3 days to use it up. I'm gonna turn the mixer on in just a minute, and then what we're gonna do is we're gonna slowly add, after the butter and sugar cream for about 3 minutes, we're gonna slowly add 5 tablespoons of butter, which is 1/3 cup, okay? And you gotta be really careful. You wanna go slow, because we don't want the butter to cook the eggs. They call it the egg yolks cooking as a technique with the sugar. It's a chemical reaction that you're looking for. So we're gonna keep getting that really fluffy. The ingredients are really funny in this recipe, in that it really is kind of an ooey gooey, creamy peach cake. It is not the type of recipe that you're gonna serve to put out in a fancy buffet, but trust me, it is so delicious. So now we're gonna add the flour. And remember, all these ingredients are up on our website, mysuncoast.com, and the baking powder. And we're gonna go ahead and we're gonna whip that, slow that down a little bit. And very slowly, I'm gonna start to incorporate 6 tablespoons of milk. Now, I've tried several recipes with almond milk, things like that. You really need to bake with whole milk unless you get a recipe where it's already been adjusted to another type of milk. But this is where you need to use your whole milk. It's only 6 tablespoons. So now that this is mixed up, when we come back, I'm going to fold in those fresh peaches from Yoder's, and I'm making a little blueberry compote to go on the base, and we are going to have a really good peach cream cake in just a few minutes. That's right. I feel like this is the version of the ooey gooey cake that everybody knows from the Midwest. So now we have, and look, it's a small amount of batter. It's just gonna fit that one pan. We're gonna add the equivalent of about 7 peaches. And I'm gonna show you as we just kind of fold it in. They're just cut up peaches, and they're gonna blend together. And you can tell you have enough when it's consistently just the peaches are coated, but there's not too much cake batter. So we could probably use about 2 more peaches, but for time's sake, we'll go ahead and leave it like that. Now, the best way to peel peaches is to drop them in a pot of boiling water for about 30 seconds, then just pull them out, let them cool slightly, wear your gloves, and the skin will peel right off. That's really the easiest way. Now, I'm gonna use a cheesecake pan, and what I've done is I've buttered it very well. Then you put on the outer part, you put aluminum foil. That's gonna keep the gooiness to the cake. Now we're gonna take some parchment paper. And what you wanna do with the parchment paper, so you don't have seams that will really affect the cake, is just kind of spread it out. You do wanna have the parchment coming up the sides, which you normally don't do. You just cut the circle on the base of it. But the reason why I wanna do this is because it's gonna be easier to lift. Because when I say the cake is gooey, it's gooey. So let's go ahead and add that to the pan, right like that, okay? Then we're gonna sprinkle the top just with a little more sugar, and that's gonna almost give it like a caramelized effect as it bakes in the oven. So you can use regular sugar. You don't wanna use powdered sugar on that. Now, you can put powdered sugar once the cake is completely baked, but I don't want it, it's already sweet. I don't wanna get it too sweet. So I'm gonna pull, see where that fold is right there. We're just gonna make sure we get this all to the corners. This is gonna go on a cookie sheet, baked at 350 to 355 degrees, about 50 to 60 minutes. Now for the blueberry compote, this couldn't be any easier. 1 to 2 pints of blueberries, a little bit of water, and 2 tablespoons of sugar, cook it down. We have it done. I'm coming back. The cake may not be gorgeous, but it's absolutely delicious. You've got it. It's ooey.
Tell Skin what it is.
It's buttery. So this is a peach cream cake, and you do have to leave the parchment paper on it, but I've covered it with blueberry compote and homemade whipped cream.
It's good, and I'll tell you, there's some other good recipes in her new cookbook.
Ta-da.
Judy Gallagher's cookbook. Check it out on Amazon and Barnes & Noble.
And Barnes & Noble online. Bookstores will have it in about 3 weeks. Reflections and recipes of Chef Judy.
Good stuff. So is the hat.
Thanks, John.
Scott.